form of filing. So so notice that there is a laundry list of stuff that we need to be mindful of. You must have a written declaration that the good is qualified as originating. You must provide the number and the date of entry. You must give a copy of certificate of origin, a written statement whether importer of good provided the entry summary, and whether there has been any refund or awareness of the refund. You have the fourth section is a written statement whether the protest has been or request for the reliquidation has been filed. So notice this is a laundry list 1 through 4, and customs usually test on laundry list as by providing you a question which is not, so they all of the stuff will be included in a laundry list but with that one particular question. So let's see how it's been tested. Which of the following statements is not required when filing a protest claim? So unlike the previous question where you have a must, you have one that is not. So you will have a laundry list of items, right? Four of them will be correct and one of them will be out. All right, so let's take a look. Statement indicating the basis of appraisement used in determining the value of the shipment, meaning the transaction value, computed value, etc. Well, that's an interesting proposition. So we know that the certificate of origin is part of part of the requirement, copy of the certificate of origin. So I just brought up one such copy of the certificate of origin, and notice you kind of have to provide the net cost, right? And you have to provide the cretursion, and in the instruction we can see that the net cost itself here, right, contains original value requirement, right, and if there is net cost, right? So we talked from the last class, from the previous class, we know that the original value content can be determined based upon the transaction value method or the net cost method. So so if you have the point here, if you're using the net cost, then transaction value, of course, is out of the question. But at the same time, transaction value comes into play under this provision, right? The goods so you have to indicate the preference criteria and tariff change, right? Original value content requirement. If you are using original value content requirement here, you kind of have to you have to provide the transaction value or net cost transaction value method or net cost method. And here's when transaction value method comes in into the play. And for transaction value, of course, you have to have a transaction value, which means you have to know how you determine that transaction value. So in a derivative kind of way, you kind of making a statement indicating basis of appraisement through the copy of the certificate of origin. But again, this is derivative thinking. Recall, I tell you that if it's not straight, if it's not fit for fit, match for match, then most likely it's not the best answer choice. So what I would do is I would put more like 4 answer choice. For answer choice A, as I analyze this, I wouldn't cross it out right away. I would put like a question mark over here. So let's go on to B. So again, we're looking for the one that's not required. So statement indicating whether or not importer of good provided a copy of the entry, summary, or equivalent documentation to any other person. Copy of entry summary equivalent documentation statement by the importer is part of the laundry list. So we're looking for the one that's not, right? So B is out. We have C, declaration that the good qualified as originating good at the time of importation. Well, that can be done. Well, it's origin declaration in addition to certificate of origin. So certificate of origin is also a way of making that statement too, but as you can see, procedure is procedure. So this one is also on the list, so C is out. And for this type of questions, I always think it's better to have this laundry list in front of you because it's always difficult to remember everything. So having this out, or at least having a reference framework in the form of where you look at, well, you look at here, 18132. If you have 18132's statute out, you can also get there as well. But I'm trying to make this user friendly. Here is the way the procedure is, right? So here is a laundry list of stuff, filing procedures, right? 1 through 4, 1 through 5. I broke it down by condensed version. They have it broken down this way. So I guess you can do it by looking at the CFR in a meaningful way as well. So it's really a personal preference in a way. But let's go back to the to the quiz break. So C is out. Protest or petition statement is contained over here. So D is out as well because it's a requirement and we're looking for the one that's not required. And statement as to whether or not the importer is aware of any claim for refund, waiver, reduction in duties relating to the merchandise is word for word copy and paste provided in here. That means C is out of the question. So this means that we only have one answer choice, which can provide a meaning. As you recall, it's in derivative thinking kind of way. It can be provided through the copy of the certificate of origin, but this is derivative thinking. So obviously this is the best answer choice because it is not straight to point. So pick A for this answer choice. All right.